My name is Desiree, and right now we're in Chiara Manzini's lab. I'm working on congenital muscle dystrophies and dystroglycanopathies. I'm originally from Frankfurt. I'm the second child, so we're four. When I was young, I was like, hey, I want to be a scientist. It looks so cool, like all these formulas. So I was like, okay, let's start with biochemistry. So I went to Southern France to study life science. I tried to get an animal model for eye disease called retinitis pigmentosa. So elder people get it like at the age of 65 and they're ending up with tunnel vision or they even be totally blind. So we tried to model one specific disease in this disease group family in zebrafish because they have a similar eye structure. That is how I ended up here because Chiara is using zebrafish to model this muscle disease and mimic some characteristics of muscular dystrophies in the zebrafish. So muscular dystrophy is like a rupture in the muscle structure. The muscle can exert the correct function, so it can't put pressure, they can't relax and contract in the correct manner. And we try to see why and how that can happen. We can associate some problems in specific genes to what may actually happen in patients. Use a fish to target these genes to re-establish muscle function or less bad structural degeneration of the fish. Well, you come in the morning. Well, the first thing I do is I get my coffee because I don't have coffee at home. The most important thing is getting on the database of articles to see if somebody has maybe already published something on your subject. If not, you're lucky. We want to visualize some proteins in distinct regions of the fish. It's called immunohistochemistry, so basically visualizing proteins with a fluorescent dye, and that will be in a distinct structure, maybe the eye, maybe the muscle. It's really interactive because in each lab it's different. You always be focused on your main idea or your main interest, but you can just miss something because you're too focused. I'm working with an undergraduate, so she's showing me how they've been doing the research right now. For me, it's shifting my focus. The microscope has to be adjusted correctly. Since you're doing really, really thin sections, you have to use a microscope. So basically, once you have done the sections, you have to analyze all the slices that they're really nice. You take pictures and you have to analyze the pictures together with collaborators. Wow. Some are good, some are not good. And I hope that there are some good sections I can then stain. 20 years ago, nobody has been thinking of using zebrafish. I mean, there were some pioneers using it to model disease. I hope it would be more and more common using the fish and then do the clinical studies, and hopefully we reduce the percentage of people having specific diseases like muscle dystrophies. Follow your heart. If you're passionate, well, there'll be obstacles, but we still like it.